WFTDA.tv.
Hey, this is Dan from S1 Helmets. We're in the testing lab today, testing helmets to see if they pass the multiple impact certification test. We're going to be testing three helmets today. A soft foam helmet with EVA foam and a terry cloth liner. The hockey helmet with triple density EVA foam. The S1 Lifer helmet with EPS fusion foam. All three of these helmets are marketed as multiple impact helmets. We're gonna test all of them today and see which ones actually pass the test. The multiple impact test is when we drop a helmet to achieve a velocity of 4.57 meters per second. This simulates a 10 mile an hour impact or a 4 foot drop. The same helmet is tested three times in the same location. The helmet must reduce the energy pulse to under 300 Gs each time. Anything over 300 Gs can result in a traumatic brain injury or a severe concussion. In summary, the soft foam helmet with EVA foam and the hockey helmet with triple density foam did not pass the multiple impact test. The S1 Lifer helmet with EPS fusion foam did pass the multiple impact test.
Plastic Patrick live at Trackside in Salt Lake City. These are the Division I playoffs of the WFTDA. Last game. Now, in case you haven't been watching all day, but I know you have, I'm just going to recap who placed where. Number 10 was Oklahoma. Number 9, Tri-City. Number 8, Wasatch, our hosts. Number 7, No Coast out of Lincoln, Nebraska. Number 6, arch rival. Number 5, Montreal. Number 4, Charm City. Number 3, Rocky Mountain. Which brings us to this next bout. The bout of all bouts this weekend. Bay Area versus Angel City of Los Angeles. Now, both teams have already received invitations to championships in Nashville along with the winner of the previous bouts, Rocky Mountain. Now, first place, the winner of this bout will get a bye in the first round of championships, and also the bragging rights of winning the Battle of California Dreaming. San Francisco, Los Angeles, it's going to be hot. Bay Area holds a record of 5 wins against Angel City. So Angel City has never beaten them. However, they played twice this year. Once in June, where Bay Area won 300 to 81, favoring Bay Area. In June, 169 to 84, again favoring Bay Area, but a much, much shorter gap between the scores. Now, Bay Area, of course, they want to win. Angel City want to beat them for the first time because they've never beaten them, but the gap has shortened a lot. Is this the night where Angel City is finally going to take the title of best team in California and the winners of the 2014 playoffs in Salt Lake City, Utah? We shall see momentarily. I'm going to throw it over to our friends over there to introduce the two teams that will be competing, Bay Area and Arch and Angel City.
Number 1286, Booty Ninja. Number 1, 337, Mickey Grimmel. Number 16, Chicago Lightning. Number 166, Jane Wilkins. Number 3, Soledad. Number 308, Britches and Hoes. Number 33, Lacey Knight. Number 360, Chrissy Crash. Number 507, Rachel Rotten. Number 5354, Chinese Checker. Number 666, Satan's Little Helper. Number 95, Tyra Shanks. And number B00M, Stormy Heather. Let's hear it for the Angel City Derby Girls.
And introducing to you the Bay Area All-Stars. Number 0, Slavia Majora. Triple 0, Demanda Riot. Number 10, Hudson. Number 1619, Bell Right Hooks. Number 21, Lulu Lockjaw. Number 238, Karen von Punchhausen. Number 32, Knock Knock. Number 45, Dolly Rocket. Number 48, Bricktator. Number 505, Shannon Baldorado. Number 52, Kid Ace. Number 7, Murderin' Monroe. Number 888, Brawlin' Angel. And number 9, Amanda Jamadinha. Let's give it up for the Bay Area All-Stars.
All right. Hello, everybody, and welcome to the championship game here on WFTDA-TV. Division One playoffs in lovely Salt Lake City. I am Tara Armoff, and I am joined by Miss Moxie. Bay Area versus Angel City. The freeway challenge.
The freeway series.
Yes, the freeway series is what I would call it. But I like Plastic Patrick's description of California Dreamin'.
Absolutely, California Dreamin'. It is also kind of a battle of gold out here, as Angel City is in white with the gold helmets. Bay Area in black with gold helmets. And we have just about 1 minute 30 seconds left to go in this game, before this game.
And while we have that time, let's give a little shout-out to the refs.
Yeah.
I want to name them off. It's Lauren Order, Colin Deschatz, John Dilks, The Pantychrist, Rage Appropriate, Freddie Mercenary, Biggie Talls, and Cruel Hand Luke are our skating refs for this game.
All right, so as we know, this is the championship game here in the third Division One playoff tournament of this series. Both teams going to Nashville for champs, of course, but the first place team here will get a bye in the first round, which is always nice to have if you're traveling a long way, as both these teams coming from California will be. You get to see your potential matchups before you play against them. So that is definitely something that both of these teams are looking for. Plus that shiny trophy over there underneath the scoreboard. It's real pretty.
That's really, really pretty. Everyone wants it.
Right. And history has Bay Area taking this game 5 wins and 0 losses. Angel City, however, has been working so hard over the past, several years, but just in the past year have shown that they are a team to contend with. Bay Area by no means taking them lightly, and as we have seen all day long, Tara Armoff, I think we are going to have a great game.
Well, and as we heard Plastic Patrick go over the scores, and the interesting thing about this year's games is how Angel City was able to cut Bay Area's point differential in half in just a few months' time. So it'll be interesting to see what happens in this game. Bay Area having lead jammer in the form of Knock Knock. And she's going up against Chicago Lightning. Chicago Lightning finally getting out of the pack for Angel City. Again, Angel City in white, Bay Area in black.
And during that jam, we did have one blocker apiece having a seat in the notorious RED penalty box. So on the Fast Girl Skates start line, we're going to have 3-on-3. Both jammers, of course, on the track. That's number 21, Lulu Lockjaw, with a star for Bay Area. Number 1337, Mickey Krimmel, jamming for Angel City.
Now, Angel City changing up their jammer rotation.
They did today.
They did. Now, they came into this tournament without Ghetto Fabulez, one of their go-to jammers. And today, for this game, they decided to switch out Chris Dobbins with Stormy Heather, who has been on the roster most of the season, but not necessarily getting a lot of game time in some of these games. I think this will be the first game that she is playing against Bay Area.
Yeah, and her first game this weekend, of course.
Yes. So Mickey Krimmel on her scoring pass. She is lead jammer for Angel City.
And Lulu Lockjaw still contending with that now four wall of Angel City blockers.
Including Chrissy Crash, Soledad, and Rachel Rotten in the back.
I believe.
Murderin' Monroe trying to come back and help Lulu Lockjaw through. Lulu is through on her initial pass.
Mickey is scoring, however, so she's going to pick up four big Angel City points. We have a tie game.
Yes, we do. And we got an interesting little stat here as to maybe why Chris is not skating in this game, because in eight jams against in the Rocky game yesterday, she had four box trips and only 24 points for that game.
Not so good.
She was the fourth-ranked point scorer for Angel City in that game. So that might be why they're taking a different route today. Number 48, Brick Tater, jamming for Bay Area, going up against 666, Satan's Little Helper, who gets out and gets lead.
And in the magical turn two, Brick Tater is also out and able to score, but it is Satan's Little Helper hitting the pack first. She's going to pick up 2 points, call off the jam. We now have a six-point game for Angel City, four for Bay Area. And Rydell Skates, unmatched quality, unmatched performance. Check them out at rydellskates.com.
And we got a nice message from Bam Bam watching on the internet. So two women are on a championship call. I think that's super cool. Coincidentally, so do we.
We do
like
too.
That.
And you know what? There's a bunch of women out there on the track too.
Isn't that handy?
I know.
I love it. Huck Sin, number 10, jamming for Bay Area. She gets out. She gets lead going up against Chicago Lightning, who is working on her initial pass, trying to get around Bell Wright Hooks, demand a riot.
And a grand slam snuck up the inside there by Huck Sin. And Chicago Lightning is out, but Huck Sin looking to pick up a couple more points before she calls off the jam.
She gets knocked to the infield by Chrissy Crash, picks up three points on that before calling it off, because Chicago Lightning was coming up and about to score.
That's right. She passed only Chrissy Crash. However, there were two Angel City blockers in the box, so she picked up those ghost points as well.
Bay Area at 12, Angel City at 6, 25 minutes, 54 seconds in the first half. Mickey Krimmel back on the jammer line for Angel City in white, going up against number 48, Brick Tater.
That is 32.
Sorry. Knock, knock.
And, you know, it looks like Angel City is sticking to a three-jammer rotation here, at least in the first few minutes of this game.
Have our first power jam in favor of Angel City. Track cut called on Knock, Knock. But apparently Mickey got jealous. She wanted a track cut of her own. She is also on her way to the notorious RED penalty box.
A little monkey see, monkey do, kind of similar to what we saw in the Charm Rocky Mountain game yesterday. Some you do this, I'm going to do this. And, you know, we know that Angel City and Bay Area are two pretty well-matched teams, so it doesn't surprise me.
Yes, they've definitely been studying each other quite a bit, as you can see in that three wall at the front, trying to hold back Knock Knock. Soledad back. Oh, sorry. I'm a Blobaya on our way to the notorious RED penalty box. Mickey Krimmel barely staying in bounds on her toe stops on the outside of the track. However, 5 points going to Knock Knock on that round.
So neither jammer is lead. We didn't have a lead jammer called, or we did have a lead jammer called. Mickey was the lead jammer of note, but she was sent to the penalty box, so we'll have a full 2-minute jam here.
Mickey trying to get through on another pass as Knock Knock scores 5 more points for Bay Area.
Bay Area out there full strength, and Angel City with just one in the box. That's Captain Jane Wilkins. I think she's about to join up with her teammates on the track. She is standing in the notorious RED penalty box.
Wow. Look at the grin that Knock Knock had as she came up on the pack and just swooped along the outside there and kind of rode the wave along the curve.
Knock Knock is a smiley jammer, but she's kind of tricky in that it looks like she's smiling. She's just breathing really hard. I'm not joking.
That's just her face,
That's
is what
just
you're
her
saying.
Face. That is just Knock Knock's face. But I like that people think that she's smiling because she is a very nice person.
She looks like she's a very nice person.
Yeah.
And the Bay Area fans are making themselves known in the stands, which we always love.
All right, number 4x8, Bricktator, taking the star for Bay Area against number 666, Satan's Little Helper.
Satan's Little Helper out of the pack gets lead jammer for Angel City. Both times that she has been out, she has gotten lead jammer. And it looks like one of the... Oh, Dolly Rocket on her way to the Notorious R.E.D. penalty box. 3 points for Satan's Little Helper and Angel City.
So
bad
both,
with none.
Both teams able to get their jammers out relatively quickly. The jam before we saw Mickey trapped for a little while, but that was kind of an anomaly as far as we've seen. Usually it's been one jammer will get out, the other jammer will get out relatively close behind. So that's an indication of a pretty close game. We have 31 points on the board for Bay Area, 12 for Angel City, 22 minutes left to play.
Lulu Lockjaw, number 21 for Bay Area, going up against number 16, Chicago Lightning. Chicago Lightning getting an assist by number 33, Lacey Knight, still trying to get out. And looks like Lulu gets out, gets lead. As Chicago Lightning, Bay Area, they're so good at the recycling. You guys in Northern California and the greenery. It's fantastic keeping, you know, being very nice to nature and recycling constantly.
We try.
Soledad trying to help out Chicago Lightning. Lulu Lockjaw hopping through on the infield. She gets a track cut. She goes to the Notorious R.E.D. penalty box. This is the second jammer penalty in this half for Bay Area.
Much like the previous game, we definitely are seeing many, many jammer penalties. Whether they be forearms, whether they be track cuts, we're seeing jammers go to the box. So,
Demand a Riot going to the Notorious R.E.D. penalty box now. And Chicago Lightning still not able to get out of the pack.
That's Dolly Rocket and Murder Monroe giving her a hard time there in the front.
I'm a blow by a trying to help her out and finally falls back. Chicago Lightning finally pushing her way out of the pack. However, Lulu Lockjaw out of the penalty box, back on the track.
So a bit of a penalty kill there from Bay Area.
Very good penalty kill from Bay Area on that. We hear whistles being blown.
Soledad going to the Notorious R.E.D. penalty box for a block to the head. That'd be a high block on Lulu Lockjaw.
Wow, did you see how Lacey Knight, she hit Lulu Lockjaw. Lulu barely stayed in bounds, right on the edge on her toe stops as Lacey and I think it was Ima went back and saying, oh no, you're supposed to reset back here. And she didn't have to because she didn't go out of bounds.
They're tricky like that. They like to play with your brain. So a close game here, 35 Bay Area, 16 for Angel City. And of note, Bad's jammers yesterday versus Charm City, Bricktator put up 83 points, Huxin with 82 points, Knock Knock 77, Lulu with 45, and Chantilly Mace with 18 points. Chantilly Mace not rostered today as she's got a bit of a knee injury from that Charm City game yesterday.
Number 1337, Mickey Krimmel jamming for Angel City, going up against number 10, Huxin for Bay Area. Mickey track cut because she did not reset behind Baron von Punchhausen.
And Huxin has this one all to herself for the next 30 seconds. Lead jammer, Bay Area.
Tyra Shanks also joining Mickey Krimmel in the Notorious R.E.D. penalty box.
And it is looking like a boxing match out there, Tara. I don't think either of us are very surprised by that.
No.
Both teams capable of a very physical level of play. Both teams very strong. And they're showing it.
Nice assist by Brawlin' Angel trying to break up that Angel City wall. Soledad going down and Chrissy Crash having to let Huxin go. That is 5 more points for Bay Area.
This is Huxin's first game against Angel City. She's never played the Sequoias. I think she's getting a dose of them right now.
And it looks like the Sequoias are taking a timeout, a team timeout.
Oh, this team timeout brought to you by Roller Derby Athletics. Roller Derby Athletics can change your game in 30 seconds, too. Find out more at rollerderbyathletics.com.
We're getting some great messages on the Twitters. If you want to send us more great messages, that would be fantastic. Hashtag talk number two, WFTDA. Knocklebe says, I don't care what the truth is. I think Knock Knock is smiling.
He would know. Knocklebe's a photographer near us, and he takes many pictures and has probably seen Knock Knock smiling or whatever in several of them.
Doing what Knock Knock does.
If you are watching us at home on WFTDA.tv, good for you. You're doing the right thing.
We like that.
Yeah, we like that.
If you can't be here, at least be watching. Team timeout is over. Number 32, Knock Knock, back on the jammer line for Bay Area. This is a power start for Bay Area. Mickey Krimmel standing in the notorious RED penalty box.
And we do have a 4-on-3 pack advantage for Bay Area. Number 7, Murder Monroe, playing a little offense there before she resets to defense.
Chrissy Crash just putting her body in front of a... In front of Knock Knock. Knock Knock having to call it. She didn't want Mickey to score any of the points.
Both jammers taking very different routes through that pack. Knock Knock choosing to kind of freight train her way through the middle. Mickey finding a line on the outside and sneaking up that way. Both very effective, if I do say so myself.
Bay Area 45, Angel City 16. Just over 18 minutes left in the first half on the Fast Girl Skates start line. It is number 48, Brick Tater, going up against 666, Satan's Little Helper.
I believe we have seen this matchup before. Satan's Little Helper has gotten lead jammer each time she's been out there today, and it is no different.
The announcer curse not setting in on Satan's Little Helper, but can you really curse Satan's Little Helper? She already has the power of evil on her side.
Perhaps we're actually helping her.
That might be the case.
So
Brick Tater still working on her initial pass. She has one to beat. Soledad hitting her out. Soledad also, 101, I'm a blow by ya. She gets out. Satan's Little Helper comes up on the pack. She picks up her 4 points and calls it off. Brick Tater is scoreless in that jam.
Number 666, Satan's Little Helper, top point scorer against Rocky Mountain yesterday with 73 points.
She's good like that.
She is good like that. And again, we're seeing a 1-2-3 jammer rotation for the time being from Angel City. We have not yet seen Stormy Heather.
That is true. Looks like they're staying with the tried and true right now. Number 16, Chicago Lightning, going up against number 21, Lulu Lockjaw. Chicago Lightning tried to take that inside line. She gets pushed into the infield and gets caught up in the back of the pack. Lulu has 2 Sequoias to beat at the front of the pack. That's Jane Wilkins and Rachel Rotten. Lulu gets out. Lulu gets lead.
A forearm sending number 0, Slabia Majora, to the notorious RED penalty box. We have a 4-on-3 pack advantage here for Angel City.
Lulu Lockjaw trying to stay in bounds. However, she does get the track cut. She reports to the notorious RED penalty box. That makes this a power jam advantage for Angel City. And it looks like
Lulu,
number 16.
Sorry, Lulu passed the line of no return there in the penalty box. So the NSOs there sent her on her merry way. She had to do one more lap before she could sit down.
Nice assist by Rachel Rotten as Chicago Lightning was getting held back by Demanda Riot there in the front. Chica is out. That is just her initial pass. We have Crawling on the Ground by Slabia Majora. Big hit by AJ on Chicago Lightning. Chica is on her scoring pass. Chrissy Crash trying to take out Demanda Riot.
Yeah, a little bit of man on or woman on offense, as it were. A low block sending Slabia Majora back to the notorious RED penalty box. And number 21, Lulu Lockjaw, is free and trying to score points. Yeah, I guess I can't.
If you call getting knocked around by Chrissy Crash, Jane Wilkins, and Rachel Rotten free, well, yes, she is very free. And Chicago Lightning, she's not even trying to get through that three wall right now. Dolly Rocket, AJ, and Demanda Riot. One of the Sequoias on their way to the notorious RED penalty box. That's Chrissy Crash. Lulu Lockjaw gets through for 5 points. Chicago Lightning also scoring 5 points in that jam. Bay Area 50, Angel City 25, 14 minutes, 30 seconds in the first half.
So we have, as far as penalties go, nobody with more than two right now. Lacey Knight, Chrissy Crash, Chinese Checker, and Mika Spedia, Jane Wilkins, and Soledad, all with two for Angel City. On the Bay Area side of things, Slabia Majora, Lulu Lockjaw at two, but that's about it.
Lulu has the high amount of penalties on Bay Area. Very clean overall, even though that is two jammer penalties given up to Angel City. Huckson, number 10, out, and lead jammer for Bay Area.
Huck has received the lead jammer nod 3 out of 3 of her jams out here, picking up a grand slam on her way through that pack.
Mickey Krimmel caught up in the pack. She's having a tough time getting out of there, and a back block penalty on Mickey. She goes to the notorious RED penalty box. This is now a power jam advantage for Huckson and the Bay Area Derby Girls. Chrissy Crash also getting a back block, also on her way to the notorious RED penalty box. We saw this yesterday when they played Rocky Mountain. Angel City has to keep those penalties under control.
They do. You know, since they're so well matched, Tara, I think both these teams are really going to try hard to keep their penalties under wraps. Grand slam,
oh,
Huckson.
Big jam for Huckson and Bay Area Derby Girls.
That was a 20-point jam for Huck, and bad 70 on the board now for Bay Area, 25 for Angel City. 13 minutes left to go. Roller Bones and Bones Bearings, they make for a winning combination. Check them out at rollerbones.com.
Number 32, Knock Knock on the Fast Girl Skate start line, going up against number 666, Satan's Little Helper.
So both Chicago Lightning and Satan's Little Helper with 9 points on the board for Angel City. Mickey Spedia at 7.
Bay Area doing a really nice job building that wall right off the bat, right on that Fast Girl Skate jammer line. And this is the first time that Satan's Little Helper has not gotten lead jammer status in this game. She is trying to catch up to Knock Knock.
Knock hits the pack and goes down hard. She does pick up 2 points for her efforts, however.
And I think that is the first time that Satan's Little Helper has not scored at all in this game.
Right. Just 2 points against her, but, you know, two big points.
Not little points.
They're not little.
Not even medium-sized points.
No,
big. These,
you know what?
Huge.
Every single point scored out here today is going to be a big point.
Number 48, Brick Tater. Jamming against number 16, Chicago Lightning. And Angel City building that wall in the back. Chicago Lightning almost having problems getting around her own defense. She manages to stay in bounds, meeting bad defense in the front. Brick Tater almost through on the inside, gets pushed out. She takes that outside edge, but it's Chicago Lightning who gets through first and picks up lead for Angel City. This is the first time Chicago Lightning has gotten lead jammer for Angel City in this game.
She's going to attempt to pick up some points, but be denied on the outside there. We have big goose eggs shown to us by the refs. And a 0-0 is kind of a palindrome, so this palindrome break brought to you by Radar. Cigar, toss it in a can. It is so tragic. That's a Radar palindrome.
On the Fast Girl Skate jammer line, we have Mickey Krimmel. Number 1337 for Angel City, going up against number 21, Lulu Lockjaw for Bay Area. Bay Area has the front wall, Angel City in the back, but they get pushed to the front, taking a Lulu's taking them with her, actually. She's trying to get them out. She gets out. She gets lead for Bay Area.
Lulu does this funny thing. More often than not, if she exits the pack and gets a lead jammer nod, you'll see her adjust her wrist guards.
I noticed that yesterday.
It's a bit of a baseball thing where they, like, step out of the batter's box and then adjust their, you know, batting gloves. I think it's just a little quick reset that she does.
Nice work by Shannon Ball Dorado holding back Mickey Krimmel. Mickey finally making it out. But Lulu Lockjaw through for 5 points. And she's going at a casual pace there.
Lulu seeing Captain Brawlin' Angel headed to the notorious RED penalty box and trying to burn, you know, any amount of time she could off that penalty for her. Again, a good heads-up call from Coach G Money on the sidelines.
Angel City has been held scoreless for three jams in a row so far.
Hucks in, top scorer for Bay Area with 38 points. Chicago Lightning still top scorer for Angel City with 9.
666, Satan's Little Helper, jamming for Angel City, going up against number 10, Huxin. Huxin getting taken to the back of the pack. Satan's Little Helper dancing along that outside line. She gets taken out, but she is able to come back in because the blockers were out of play. She is lead jammer for Angel City. And now we have a power jam in favor of Angel City as Huxin goes to the notorious RED penalty box.
Huck's first penalty and consequently her first non-lead jammer. Captain Brawlin' Angel out of the penalty box, attempting to play a little bit of defense there on Satan's Little Helper, but
Nice timing on her part just as she was coming out. She was within bounds, within 20 feet of the pack, and Satan's Little Helper getting stopped by AJ at the front of the pack. She spins out of it, picks up another 5 points for Angel City.
Satan's Little Helper taking her time here. She knows that she owns this jam.
Huxin out of the box, back on the track. Comes up against Jane Wilkins in the back, taking Satan's Little Helper with her. Both reset quickly. Huxin out on her initial pass. AJ smacking Satan's Little Helper down into the infield. Satan's Little Helper picks up an additional 3 points on that jam, calls it off before Huxin is able to score any of the points. That puts Angel City at 38 to Bay Area's 77, 7 minutes, 46 seconds in the first half of this game. And looky here, looks like we have a little mix-up,
we're spicing up the
lineup. Boom! Stormy Heather, first time jamming for Angel City, going up against number 32, Knock Knock.
I hear a whistle. That means somebody's going to the box. Both packs already down one blocker. We have one each sitting in the notorious RED penalty box, and that will be two now for Angel City. So we have a 3-on-2 pack advantage for Bay Area.
Knock Knock coming up for her first scoring pass, coming up against I'm a Blow Baya.
A multiplayer block being assessed to...
Oh, that is Bridges and Hose, another newer member of Angel City's Hollywood Scarlets.
So Knock Knock picking up 5 points, 82 Bay Area, 38 Angel City. That Angel City penalty box looking pretty full, the notorious RED penalty box. So they're going to start with two in the box, 2-on-4 pack advantage here for Bay Area.
Chrissy Crash, Soledad, the only blockers for Angel City on the track. They're talking to their jammer, Chicago Lightning, number 16, but it is number 48, Bricktator, who begins the push through, trying to take the friendly side through, coming up against Chrissy Crash and Soledad at the front of the pack.
A dynamic duo there in the front of the pack. They do hang on to Brick for a little bit, but she does pick up that lead jammer nod here for Bay Area.
Chicago Lightning getting pushed to the infield by Murderin' Monroe. She gets the track cut. That means this is another power jam advantage for Bay Area.
I didn't even see Murderin' Monroe come out of the notorious RED penalty box, and then she had pulled that track cut.
She is sneaky, that little
She's Murderin' like a ninja.
Monroe. She's the blondest ninja I've ever seen.
So now Angel City at full strength and really giving Bricktator the business out there.
Lacey Knight getting up to her wall, but Bricktator actually just powering through. Lacey Knight resetting. Soledad and Chrissy Crash trying to prop them up. Chicago Lightning back on the track. 5 more points for Bricktator and the Bay Area Derby Girls.
Lacey Knight having a seat in the notorious RED penalty box for Angel City for a low block. Meanwhile, back at the ranch, another high five for Bricktator and Bay Area.
Chicago Lightning not able to get around Brawlin' Angel, Murderin' Monroe there in the front of the pack. That three wall is, it's not a stop block, but they have her stopped. It's incredible.
And
they push her off the track. She has to reset behind.
Neither team moving a whole lot here. Maybe collectively taking a breath.
And, yeah, actually, Brick Tater, she actually came back. It's like, okay, I'm going to try this again. And the jam gets called.
There was a high block assess to number 52, Kid Ace, there at the end of that jam. She's going to have a seat in the notorious RED penalty box. And Angel City is going to have a 4-on-3 pack advantage here in this jam. And for all your printing needs, hit up printcographics.com.
The score, Angel City still at 38, Bay Area 97. Just under 4 minutes left in the first half of this game. Number 21, Lulu Lockjaw, jamming for Bay Area, but it's number 1337, Mickey Krimmel, out and lead jammer for Angel City Derby Girls.
This is Mickey's second lead jammer of her 7 jams.
Lulu Lockjaw getting out of the pack on her initial pass. Mickey taking the outside. She gets out. She gets 4 points. She calls it off.
So Captain Jane Wilkins having a seat in the notorious RED penalty box for Angel City. Number 52, Kid Ace, standing for Bay Area. So we'll start with 3-on-3 in the pack, but Kid Ace soon to join Bay Area on the track.
On the Fast Girl Skates jammer line, we have number 32, Knock Knock, going up against number 666, Satan's Little Helper.
Satan.
She's bouncing along.
She's bounces. Ready.
She's always ready. That's the one thing about Satan's Little Helper. It's like, ready to go out and jam? Heck yeah, I am. But it is number 32, Knock Knock, who gets out and gets lead for Bay Area. Satan's Little Helper caught up in the pack, trying to get past the three wall in front. She has one to beat, and Bell Wright hooks. Well, and then Murder Monroe decides to recycle up to the front. Satan's Little Helper dancing along on the inside, getting out on her initial pass. Knock Knock working on her scoring pass. She gets knocked into the infield. She picks up 3 points for Bay Area and calls it off. Bay Area have broken the century mark at exactly 100 points. Angel City has 42. 2 minutes, 5 seconds left in the first half of this championship game.
It is a championship game. Worthy of Notorious Gear Deodorant by Notorious R.E.D. Order online at NotoriousRED.com because you stink.
Just saying. Just letting you know.
Just putting it out there.
And again, Angel City built that wall across the Fast Girl Skates start line and so far has been effective in stopping Huxin. Oh, Huxin going to the Notorious R.E.D. penalty box.
A low block assessed to Huxin. She went down, and then someone fell on top of her, and as our officials cannot call intent, she will be sent off on a low block.
She could go lightning through for 5 points for Angel City. Bay Area has all their blockers on the track. They are lined up way across the track. She could go lightning, hitting that line along the outside. She's getting an assist from Tyra Shanks, but she gets pushed to the infield by Brawlin' Angel. And Brawlin' Angel going to the Notorious RED penalty box.
Actually, that is Dolly Rocket, accompanied by number 505, Shannon Baldorado, headed to the Notorious RED penalty box. And also Tyra Shanks will join her.
5 points for Chica Go Lightning. Huxin out of the box, back on the track. She has completed her initial pass. Chica Go Lightning through for 4 more points.
Huxin trying to steal a couple there at the end, but was unable. A big jam there for Angel City, bringing them to 56 points. Bay Area is still sitting pretty at 100.
The penalty count is fairly even.
It is fairly even. It's also fairly high. We have 21 trips to the box for Bay Area, 24 for Angel City. And as I happen to know that Bay Area likes to keep their penalties for an entire game below 25, I'd say they're, not too stoked with that at this moment.
They are very disappointed, maybe.
They're going to work on it.
Number 48, Brick Tater, jamming for Bay Area, going up against number 1337, Mickey Krimmel for Angel City. Bricktator getting out, getting lead.
And of Bricktator's six jams, this is only her second lead jammer call. She does have the opportunity to score some points now, however, as Mickey being recycled to the back of the pack by Bay Area.
That's right, Shannon Ball Dorado forcing her out and forcing her back. Now Murder and Monroe keeping her back there. And it looks like Bricktator, oh, she makes it through. That is 5 points for Bay Area. She comes up for another scoring pass as Mickey Krimmel still held in the pack, not picking up any points. Two more points for Bay Area before that jam is called. It is halftime.
And we're going to let you know some penalty and point recaps. Tara, who's in the box there?
The high penalty count winners for this half.
Winners.
Well, sure. Well, Lacey Knight, number 33, she is sitting on 4 penalties for Angel City. And Shannon Baldorado sitting on 3 penalties. So even though Bay Area has more penalties than they want, there's no one who has more than 3, which isn't too shabby. Could be worse.
Nobody too close to the danger zone here. I think 3-4 penalties at the half, especially given the really physical game that we are seeing, is actually pretty decent. So as far as points go, we still have some top point scorers here. 38 points is the top for Bay Area, and that is Huck Sin. Knock Knock behind her with 33. Bricktator at 22 points. Lulu Lockjaw with 14. And on the Angel City side, Chicago Lightning, top point scorer for them with 23 points. Just behind her is 22 points for Satan's Little Helper. Mick Espedia is at 11, and Stormy Heather, with just one jam under her belt so far in this game, has not picked up any points.
All righty then. What else can we talk about? Let's see. Well, again,
we can talk about we're getting ready to...
talk to us, actually, at hashtag talk number 2 at WFTDA. They just sang happy birthday to the referee, Panty Christ. So isn't that delightful?
That is very sweet. Happy birthday, Panty Christ. And we are also going to give away the booty basket here in about a minute. That's a very exciting basket full of goodies that one lucky winner will take home with them.
They get all kinds of treats.
All kinds of treats. From all the vendors and sponsors, and it's like Derby Christmas.
All right, and we are going to throw this to the Booty Basket Giveaway.
Buy Antic skate boots, you buy some other brand. When you buy some other brand, you suck at practice. When you suck at practice, you're unprepared for Team Antic USA skater Carmen Getsum. When you're unprepared for Carmen Getsum, she destroys you on the track. When she destroys you on the track, you end up on the trainer's table with a concussion and major injuries. Don't end up with a concussion and major injuries. Buy Antic skate boots. We'll be right back.
told us to just sell skates online. You won't have any overhead. Put some skulls in your advertising, you'll make a mint. That was never our plan. Our plan was to make a store where all day we are fitting skaters, fixing skates, teaching customers, and putting the best gear on their bodies. Before we put 3 W's in front of our name, we made sure we had hundreds of happy customers come through our doors. We're not just Derby owned, we're Derby dedicated. Fast Girl Skates.
Hello and welcome back.
We've replaced redheads.
Yeah, the look-alike, Twisted Sister, Roller Derby Ramones, whatever you wanted to call the arm-off Moxie combination was too much.
It was too much.
Too much for the call, and so Double H, you are stepping in.
I'm a pinch hitter. That's what I do.
Yes.
Team player.
Wear your glasses. I think you need to be wearing your glasses.
Oh, right.
Just to
at least
play along.
The full Lisa Loeb call. Here we go. All right. So, yes, unfortunately, Moxie not feeling well. She has not been feeling well today, so we hope that she does feel better. And her team, Bay Area, on top now, 107-56 over Angel City at the half. And we saw Bay Area really rattled by Angel City in the first half.
Yes, that is
true. The first 10 minutes.
Yes, that is true. And Angel City has never won against Bay Area, but they have closed the gap. And this score is reflecting that as well. There have been times when Bay Area would be, 300 points ahead. And that is definitely not the case now. Angel City has definitely been doing their homework, and it reflects in the score. Now, the penalty count is interesting because Angel City is kind of paying for that determination in the form of penalties. But the game has started. Number 666, Satan's Little Helper, is jamming for Angel City, going up against number 32, Knock Knock.
Nice job at the back from Bay Area, forcing Satan's Little Helper into position, almost able to get past the front there, Tara.
Yeah, she almost got by Shannon Baldorado, but she did not. And Knock Knock going up against I'm a Blow By Ya. And sneaking around that front Angel City defender, and she gets lead jammer for Bay Area.
Rachel Rotten dropping back to provide a little offense for her jammer.
Knock Knock going around her own blocker. She is on her scoring pass. She gets knocked to the infield. She is having to reset behind Chrissy Crash, Jane Wilkins, and Rachel Rotten waiting. Nice bracing by Ima Blobaya.
Pushing out of bounds, Knock Knock. Rachel Rotten denying Knock Knock right now in this jam.
Rachel Rotten going up for the assist for Satan's Little Helper, but it's not enough to get her out of the pack. That is scoreless for Angel City. 3 points for the Bay Area Derby girls.
So a completely unrelated question on Twitter. Anyone know when Desi Creation is due? Yes, she is due the same day my son is due, was due, and I birthed him, November 28th. So congratulations to Desi Creation and Kool-Aid for their expectant child.
Looks like number 1337, Mickey Speedia, jamming for Angel City, going up against number 21, Lulu Lockjaw. Lulu Lockjaw facing the wall of Sequoias in the back. Mickey Speedia trying to push Bay Area blockers out of play, trying to get that 20 feet. She gets pushed out, getting an assist by Tyra Shanks. But again, Bay Area, the recycling is just so phenomenal. Lulu Lockjaw gets out, gets lead for Bay Area.
The thing I love about Lulu Lockjaw is she's got such great upper body strength. She's able to push her chest against those walls, and it works out in her favor. She finds that crack, and she exploits it.
She's very wiggly.
She is very wiggly, and she's able to use her shoulder to pry open a little hole and get through.
And she uses that shoulder to get 5 points for Bay Area. Mickey Krimmel still working on her initial pass. She has to reset behind Demanda Riot. And number 238, Baron Von Punchhausen. And she doesn't want to risk getting a penalty. She doesn't want to get beaten up anymore. And this is a real testament to Bay Area's defense, because Angel City is a team, their cross training is CrossFit, and they take it very seriously. And you could tell by their physiques.
I gotta say, that was beautiful work there from Lacey Knight, just dropping back to open a hole for her jammer. Unfortunately, no points scored there for Angel City. The score, Bay Area 119, Angel City 56, just under 27 minutes in the second half. And we'd like to thank Bonk Skates, lighter, stronger, faster, fully heat moldable and customizable carbon fiber boots. Go to bonk.com for more.
Standing on the Fast Girl Skates jammer line, we have number 48, Brick Tater for Bay Area, and number 16, Chicago Lightning for Angel City. And in case you haven't figured it out, Bay Area is in black, Angel City is in white.
Good reminder.
Just for the few people who would be tuning in at halftime instead of watching the whole game as they should be. Nice work by Soledad, forcing Brick Tater to reset at the back of the pack. And Chicago Lightning getting out, getting lead. This is the first lead jam that Angel City has had in this half of the game.
So that was Murder in Monroe at the end of that escape, who followed, that was following Chicago Lightning out of the pack. Great work here defensively from Bay Area, and I expect no less from the number one seed in this tournament.
Not too shabby on the Angel City side as well. Brick Tater. Oh! Nice move by Brick Tater. She figured out an open space to take. She finally gets out on her initial pass. Chicago Lightning scoring 5 points and calling it off for Angel City.
Chicago Lightning has 28 points in this game. She's the top point scorer right now for Angel City, followed by Satan's Little Helper, number 666. And no points yet for Stormy Heather, who is taking the Fast Girl Skate start line right now against Huck Sin, who's got 38 points in this game.
Stormy Heather had one jam in the first half of the game. She did not score any points, and so she sat out the rest of the half. So Angel City is going to try again. Angel City walling it up in front. Stormy Heather has two to beat at the front of the pack. Well, now three. Bell Wright hooks and Demand a Riot. And number 505, Shannon Baldurado. And Stormy Heather in her second jam of the game gets lead.
She comes out of that pack smiling, but that was such great work at the back from Bell Wright Hooks to do that bridge work to keep her in as long as she did. On a scoring run now, though, Stormy Heather gets her hips around. Nice work there from her to grab 2 points for Angel City.
And no points for Bay Area.
Well, I was going to say Little Rock Low on Twitter saying, AJ having an HE double hockey sticks of a game. I agree with you on that one.
That AJ, she's a good skater.
No penalties yet either. 13 jams she skated in, absolutely no penalties.
And as Miss Moxie was saying in the first half of the game, Bay Area really prides themselves on not getting penalties like they used to. And I remember once upon a time when AJ would get a lot of penalties with different teams.
Oh, speaking too soon right there. We have back-to-back jammer penalties, both forearms.
That's interesting. Both Knock Knock and Satan's Little Helper taking a little micro break there in the notorious RED penalty box. Both are back on the track. Angel City, only three blockers. Oh, fourth one is coming out of the notorious RED penalty box. Bridges and Hose comes up, trying to give the assist to Satan's Little Helper. Satan's Little Helper, though, just caught behind AJ. And as soon as she gets past one, they all recycle up, waterfall up, and stop her forward progression.
She is doing a really good job there, though, Bridges, trying to get in front of the opposing blockers and just sitting long enough for her jammer to push past the opposing blocker next to her and open a hole. This is definitely the slower of the slowest jams that I've seen in quite a while here.
It is quite glacial, I must say. It's been a long time since I've seen such a slow game with this much violence.
All right, so Bridges is coming over not just to offer some offense, but perhaps a little bit of star pass help potentially. She's staying within zone, but that is going to be a cutting call against Satan's Little Helper.
That's the second penalty in this jam for her.
And I was wondering if Bridges was trying to set up a star pass. It did not happen.
Knock Knock trying to get through Angel City. Bay Area kind of helping, kind of not. They're trying to pull Ima Blobaya out of that wall. Rachel Rotten comes up to reset. They're trying to build that wall in the front. Bridges and Hose getting caught up, kind of a semi-goading situation. And it's interesting because Knock Knock just standing in the back of the pack. That was the most interesting jam I've seen this weekend, I think.
She just looked exhausted, and I think she wasn't quite sure whether to even risk going any further, potentially getting in penalty trouble. But she has two in this game so far for Bay Area, so she's doing well.
On the Fast Girl Skates jammer line, or actually 10 feet behind the Fast Girl Skates jammer line, is number 21, Lulu Lockjaw for Bay Area. This is a power start for Angel City. Satan's Little Helper dances back onto the track.
That's been a position of power for Lulu off the line. She likes to be about 10 feet back from it and find a way to be explosive in that momentum, and she does it so well.
That is her thing that she likes to do. She's facing a three wall of sequoias in front. However, she pulls it apart, gets out, and gets lead for Bay Area.
Nice work here. Oh, just teetering on one skate. That's Demanda Riot. She's able to stay in bounds and offer some offense for Lulu.
Looks like Mickey Krimmel trying to assist against the Bay Area wall. Or maybe, I wonder if there was a star pass there. Yes, there was.
That was a big hit at the end from Soldad from Angel City.
Angel City, both teams looking frustrated these past couple of jams. It's fascinating.
Well, what we're talking about here is pushing, heavy, heavy pushing. This is exhausting work. This is harder than skating fast. This requires a lot of lifting practice. This requires a lot of footwork, and it is the hardest job right now. You can see Mickey really struggling, but she just has to keep pushing, even if Demanda Riot is on her.
And it looks like 2 points were scored by Bay Area, Lulu Lockjaw. No points for Angel City.
The WFTDA would like to thank Fast Girl Skates. Get your league sponsored for product discounts. Email sponsorship at fastgirlskates.com or go to fastgirlskates.com for more information. Karma Lectrek says, that was the most exhausting jam ever. I agree. I need a nap after that.
I am sure tired after watching that. Angel City 63, Bay Area 125, 19 minutes, 30 seconds left in the game. Bricktator, number 48, jamming for Bay Area, going up against number 16, Chica Go Lightning.
Chica trying to find an inside line, coming up against Shannon Baldorado.
Sorry about that. So Bricktator taking the outside line, getting out, getting lead for Bay Area.
But through, right behind her, is Chica.
And we see Angel City visiting the notorious RED penalty box.
That's Chinese Checker, and that is going to be her fourth trip to the notorious RED penalty box. So the penalty is starting to... I'm sorry, that was Lacey Knight.
Lacey Knight has 5 penalty points now. And so, we have ourselves a little timeout.
We sure do. Roller Derby Athletics can change your game in 30 seconds, too. Find out more at rollerderbyathletics.com.
And smart for Angel City to take this break. They definitely need it. They have to stop the bleeding both points-wise and penalty-wise.
Yeah, and after a jam like that, just... so much pressure. I mean, you want to be able to rest the entire team because you're going to need to put people in jam after jam after jam. And sometimes it takes a couple of jams for a jammer to be able to normalize again.
Yes, especially with the history that these two teams have. And Angel City really trying to prove to Bay Area, it's like, you think you've beat us in the past, but that's not going to be the case forever and ever. So don't get comfortable. And Bay Area can't get comfortable, and Angel City unable to get comfortable. Back on the Fast Girl Skate Jammer line, we have Stormy Heather, number Boom, for Angel City, going up against number 10, Huxin. Huxin hopping through that back wall of Bay Area, trying to get around Chrissy Crash and Tyra Shanks, the only two blockers on the track for Angel City. Stormy Heather unable to get through. Huxin out and lead jammer for Bay Area.
So this makes the 33rd penalty for Angel City. That is number 95, Tyra Shanks, headed to the notorious RED penalty box. Only 25 for Bay Area. I say 25 knowing that Bay Area does not like to get 25 penalties in a game.
Yes, that's the upper region that they find barely acceptable, and they don't like to do that. Huxin picks up 4 points, calls it off for Bay Area, 133 to Angel City, 63, just under 18 minutes left in the game.
Green Monster Roller Sports. Our skates can beat up your skates. Antic skate boots. Go to greenmonster.com. And, of course, no vowels in Green Monster.
Green Monster.
Green Monster.
Number 32, Knock Knock. Getting through, getting lead jammer right out of turn one. She's up against 1337, Mickey Krimmel. Mickey getting knocked out of bounds by Demanda Riot. She's getting frustrated. She's really getting frustrated. Demanda Riot going to the notorious RED penalty box. Knock Knock through for 5 points.
Knock Knock, the second highest point scorer in this game for Bay Area, 41 points. She is beat out only by Huxin, who's got 42 points, and it looks like Knock Knock about to take that lead on her team with another 4 points for Bay Area.
That's right. Mickey Krimmel finally making it out of the pack on her initial pass. A little too late in that jam. And it looks, and do we have a timeout? No. I saw Conan the Vegetarian run out to the middle there. I thought he was going to call a timeout or an official timeout.
Although
no.
I do see G Money, and that is going to be a timeout.
Now it's a timeout.
It says, though you willed it, Tara. You willed the team timeout that is Bay Area.
It's the power of the announcer, our evil jinxing powers.
In most life, we have absolutely no power. But for some reason today, I don't know.
Put a microphone in our face and all of a sudden we do things.
There's some voodoo going on. This is a team timeout sponsored by Roller Derby Athletics. Roller Derby Athletics can change your game in 30 seconds too. Find out more at rollerderbyathletics.com. Both teams still have both official reviews though. I'm sure they're going to want to keep those in their pockets.
And this is the second timeout that Angel City has taken, so they have one left. And Bay Area has two timeouts on their side. I'm sure they will use them to good effect.
So Twitter is screaming at us. Where's Chantilly Mason? If you weren't able to hear the first half of the game or see the first half of the game, you probably didn't hear Miss Moxie say that Chantilly Mace had banged up her knee a bit in the game yesterday, so they were sitting her today.
I'm sure she'll be okay. I think they're just taking precautions, saving her for champs. Basically.
They are going to Nashville.
Both of these teams going to Nashville, that is for sure. Number 21, Lulu Lockjaw, jamming for Bay Area, going up against number 16, Chica Go Lightning for Angel City.
Nice work here in the pack from Angel City, but that is going to be Rachel Rotten headed to the notorious RED penalty box for Angel City.
Chica Go Lightning, one by one, trying to get around the Bay Area defense. She has two to beat. She goes down on the outside.
Chica's the top point scorer now for Angel City with 28 points in the game.
And Lulu Lockjaw having her own problems trying to get out of the front of the pack. Going up against Chinese Checker and Booty Ninja.
And they're forced to let her go. She is lead jammer. That was exhausting. Almost one full minute, Tara, before lead jammer status was called.
Oh, my goodness. Chicago Lightning finally getting out, having a lot to say about it. But Lulu Lockjaw getting through, squeaking by for 4 more points for Bay Area.
Fortunately for Angel City, Rachel Rotten out of the notorious RED penalty box at the end of that one. So they will reset with a full complement of blockers on the track. The WFTDA would like to thank Adam Wheels. Adam Wheels, train hard, play smart, skate Adam, Adam Wheels. Go to adamwheels.com.
Wow, Conan the Vegetarian walking back out into the infield, having a lovely conversation, I'm sure, with the referees coming back to the Angel City bench. Satan's little helper on the jammer line for Angel City, going up against number 48, Brictator.
Satan's little helper, 22 points in this game, just behind Chica Go Lightning's 28, but out through for lead jammer status right now, that is Brictator.
This is the fifth jam in a row. I do believe that Bay Area has gotten lead jam status. Satan's Little Helper still working on her initial pass.
And there's going to be a back block call, I believe, sending
Chrissy,
that's Crash. Chrissy Crash, number 360 for Angel City, to the Notorious R.E.D. penalty box.
Satan's Little Helper making it out of the pack on her initial pass. However, number 48, Brictator, picking up 5 points and calling it off.
So Bay Area 151, Angel City 63, just about 14 minutes left in this game. Angel City looking like they're a little bit tired, but there's a great reason for that. Both of these teams are pushing really hard. These are some of the slowest walls that I've seen in a really long time, certainly all weekend.
Again, they've been doing their studying up on each other. That is for sure.
They've met.
they've met a few times. Stormy Heather jamming for Angel City up against number 10, Huxin for Bay Area. Three wall in front of Angel City. Huxin getting pushed out, having to reset behind. Stormy Heather getting pushed out. She's still working on her initial pass as Huxin gets out and gets lead.
That was gorgeous. Right through the inside, she was able to go. Not so gorgeous right now, that back block call, sending Stormy Heather to the Notorious R.E.D. penalty box. Her first penalty of the game.
Yes, it is. This is ill time for Angel City. They cannot afford any jammer penalties at all. And they are not able to stop Huxin. She is through for 5 points for Bay Area.
Bay Area 156, Angel City 63, 13 minutes left in the game.
Angel City walling it up in front, knocking Huxin to the infield. She picks up 4 more points. The jam ends. Bay Area 160, Angel City 63, 12 minutes, 40 seconds left in the game.
The WFTDA would like to thank Something Inked. We put the pro in promotions. Something Inked has your merch needs covered. Go to Something Inked, that's INKED.com.
Fast Girl Skate Jammer Line finds number 32, Knock Knock, starting in a power start for Bay Area. Three Angel City blockers on the track. Looks a little, I hear whistles being blown. Knock Knock gets out and gets lead for Bay Area. And yes, there was a whistle blown for Britches and Hose. She's on her way to the Notorious R.E.D. penalty box on the Angel City side.
Still working in the pack, though. That is Stormy Heather having come out of the Notorious R.E.D. penalty box.
I hear whistles. She goes right back to the Notorious R.E.D. penalty box for a back block.
So this has been 5 jams that she has skated in this game. She's gotten 2 penalties, both of them within the last jam and a half. And Conan running into the infield saying, "Would you like to see my wares?" No, I'm sure he wasn't saying that. I'm sure he was insisting on a call that was not made. Let's see if he turns that into a review or just a general commentary.
Oh, he is commentating away. He has lots of things to say on that infield
with
right now.
Dramatic hand gestures to boot. And I'm not seeing a review, though. Conan able to take that time that he needs, that 30 seconds, to get out there, make his point. He probably let them know that he thought certain things weren't being called or should have been called, and then just hops right back.
I think it's more about saving that official review with... Since there's just over 10 minutes left in the game, he really has to manage his time wisely, especially with the usage of timeouts that Angel City has already utilized. Lulu Lockjaw through. She is lead jammer. She has picked up 5 points for Bay Area. Angel City has a 3-wall in front. Bay Area scrambling that wall and breaking it apart. Lulu Lockjaw getting through on one skate. 5 more points for Bay Area.
She was laughing on that one for sure.
Well, she had the whole thing going with the windmilling of the arms and balancing on one skate.
So there is going to be a timeout, and it's going to be a team timeout, and it does look like it's going to be for Angel City, although we're still showing an official timeout. So let's see an official review for Angel City. All right. Just to sort of discuss the history here, Angel City played Bay Area in April 12th of this year. Angel City lost that game 300-81, and then they played 2 months later, they played Bay Area at the Golden Bowl, and they lost 169-84. So they had been decreasing that point differential. It now looks like Bay Area is kind of holding them to that.
Yeah, Bay Area apparently didn't like the point differential on that last game. Says, well, guess what? No, that's not going to happen.
We're going to roll it back.
We're going to show you, give you what, four?
Well, speaking of numbers, S1 Helmets. S1 Helmets. Get a lifer, be a lifer. Go to S1Helmets.com. That's S, the number one, Helmets.
And again, if you have anything wonderful to tweet at us, hashtag #talk2WFTDA.
Sarah on Twitter says, HE Double Hockey Sticks is being a jammer and going against Bay Area's wall over and over again. And I think that's been the name of this game. I think Angel City's doing an awesome job holding Bay Area to this score the way that they have. There's been a lot of penalties that have caused them problems, and I think they probably would have done a better job if not for some of those penalties. Okay, so the white team, that's Angel City, is challenging a no call on a cut track. So that is probably what all that wild gesturing was from Konan. He believed that there should have been a cut call, a cutting call that was not made. He was still gesturing for a minute, but now he's decided to fold his arms and save his energy.
It was a Shakespearean there for a minute. It was quite emphatic, I must say.
A former official himself, he's no stranger to all manner of hand signals.
And again, with just over 10 minutes left and using that official review, whew, it's going to be an interesting last 10 minutes for Angel City if they're not able to fall back on those timeouts in the remaining time.
And we'll take this opportunity to thank Roll Line. That's Roll-Line, a new generation of roller derby. Roll Line, proudly made in Italy. That's roll-line.it. So now Konan and G-Money having a conversation in the middle with Lauren Order. And he is still trying to describe it, but it, he does not look happy about it. So I'm guessing it was not overturned or made into a call.
The no call will stand.
Correct. The no call will stand. So that means Angel City has lost their review, Tara. All right. So we are Bay Area 179, Angel City 63. Angel City has lost their review, and we've got 10 minutes left in this game, 10 minutes and 8 seconds to be exact. Tara, was that confirmed?
Yes.
Excellent. Bricktator on Stormy Heather. Bricktator is the lead jammer now.
Tyra Shanks coming out of the notorious RED penalty box, as is Stormy Heather. Stormy Heather trying to get around Murderin Monroe and Demanda Riot, and I think AJ. Yes. Really nice work by AJ. She used to be a figure skater, and it shows in the way that she skates. Bricktator on her scoring pass. She has a front wall of Angel City to get through. She picks up 5 points for Bay Area.
Chrissy Crash headed to the notorious RED penalty box. This is her 6th penalty, Tara. She is in danger. The danger zone.
She is in the danger zone, and not in an archer type of way. Bricktator staying on the track, picking up 5 more points for Bay Area. Tyra Shanks taking another seat in the notorious RED penalty box. Bricktator getting through on one skate, calling it off. Oh, no points on that last pass. That's interesting.
I think there's some conversation about...
Okay.
That's one thing I've noticed the jammer referees doing a lot, which I think has been extremely helpful. They have taken the time to make sure that they're, and John Dilk says 5 points on that pass.
That makes more sense to me. I can't count very well, but I saw her passing some Angel City skaters.
Oh. So that is Huxin facing off against Mickey Krimmel.
Mickey Krimmel out and lead jammer for the first time in quite a few jams for Angel City. However, Huxin is also out of the pack. She is a score in some points.
I'm not sure if Mickey didn't see her or if she just wanted to keep going.
I think she's very determined to get some points. And Mickey looking around, both jammers 4 points on that pass.
Nice hit to the inside.
I'm a blow by ya, saying, no, actually, you're not going to blow by me. I'm going to hit you into the infield, and you're going to like it.
Great work from her and Jane Wilkins recycling Huxin.
I hear a back block call being made on Huxin. This is a power jam in favor of Angel City. They have 67 points to Bay Area's 198 at this point. Mickey Spedia cautiously. Nice work by Tyra Shanks faking out that partnership in the back of Bay Area. Mickey patiently trying to get through. She does not want to draw a penalty.
And she's calling it with Huxin in the notorious RED penalty box, so this will be a power start for Angel City.
And Huxin had picked up 2 points on that last pass before sitting in the notorious RED penalty box. And I'm exhausted watching
this. It is exhausting watching this bout. The WFTDA wants to thank Adam Wheels. Adam is a proud partner of the WFTDA for 6 years running. Visit adamwheels.com.
Number 16, Chicago Lightning on the Fast Girl Skate Jammer line. Getting around AJ, trying to get an assist from her team. Demanda Riot saying, no, you cannot has. But Chicago Lightning does have lead jammer, even though she gets sucked back into the pack.
I am fairly certain that's exactly what Demanda Riot said.
She totally seems like the type that would say, you cannot has.
Out of the notorious RED penalty box, of course, that is Huxin working the front three brace, getting forced to the inside from Angel City.
Chicago Lightning being able to squeak by on the inside line. Huxin still working on getting out of the Sequoia Forest. She does make it out on her initial pass.
Chica working here to get some points. She's still the top point scorer, only 28 for her team so far, but now she's going to add to that.
She takes a shirt whip off number 3, Soledad, gets through for 4 points.
Nice hit there from Lacey Knight, pushing her out of bounds.
Wow.
Getting a hit herself here.
Huxin resetting in the back. Chicago Lightning trying to get through on the outside. Huxin through for 4 points for Bay Area.
So finally getting their jammer through again is Chica. And that was a 4-point pass for Huck, who's very slowly eyeing up the back. And Chica not calling it.
I think at this point, they're just going for points. It's points.
Mm-hmm. But it's also going to be extremely exhausting if she continues. She was taking a look around to see where she was. Demanda Riot just laying her out.
Nice little hip check there as Chica tried to hop through. She still gets the points. No pass, no penalty on one of the players, so that's only 4 points for Chicago Lightning. Or no pass, no penalty on her. Huxin coming to the back, coming up against Rachel Rotten and Soledad. The jam ends. That's 2 more points for Chicago Lightning and Angels. Oh, 5 points.
Correction. The birthday referee, a.k.a. the Pantychrist, says no, it was 5 points, actually, which brings Chicago Lightning's game tally to 44. She's the top point scorer on Angel City, followed by Saints Little Helper at 22. And on the Fast Girl Skate start line, Knock Knock 32. Number 32 has got 54 points in this game.
And speaking of Satan's Little Helper, she is trying to push through that back wall on the Fast Girl Skates jammer line, but it is Knock Knock who gets out and gets lead out of turn one.
She did not hesitate, and that is what I love about Bay Area's jammers. They don't even blink. You've blinked, and they've gone.
She's gone, done on her scoring pass, taking the outside. Angel City barely able to hold onto their walls, but able to push her out. She has to reset behind Satan's Little Helper, also on her scoring pass. I hear whistles being blown. A multiplayer block called on Booty Ninja for Angel City. She's on her way to the notorious RED penalty box. That is 2 points for Satan's Little Helper.
So we should also mention that within the last jam or two, Chrissy Crash has fouled out of this game for Angel City. Lacey Knight has 5 penalties. Chinese Checker has 6 penalties. So these are starting to become problems for Angel City. In the last 3 minutes of the game, they are not going to want to deal with those types of issues as well.
Lulu Lockjaw jamming for Bay Area up against Mickey Krimmel. And that back wall Bay Area is holding is just phenomenal off the line. Angel City holding back. They have they knocked Lulu out of bounds, and they just stopped, and she stopped while Mickey pushes that front wall forward. Nice assist there by Lacey Knight. Mickey still unable to get through, and Lulu Lockjaw squeaks by on the inside and picks up lead.
So we have another penalty adding to two more penalties. That's going to be Rachel Rotten and Soledad heading to the Notorious RED penalties. Tara, that makes 50 penalties right now in this game for Angel City, 29 for Bay Area.
AJ forcing Mickey out of bounds, forcing her to reset behind Amanda Riot at the back of the pack. Five more points scored by Lulu Lockjaw. Nice assist by Lacey Knight, but it is not enough. Mickey Spedia down on the ground. It looks like her spirit is broken.
You know, that was precision waterfalling there from Bay Area to the outside. They did not hesitate. They swept 1, 2, 3, and they got her out.
Nice work by Lacey Knight at the very end of that jam as Lulu Lockjaw was coming up on another scoring pass, and Lacey almost dove across in a legal manner across the track, forcing Lulu out on the outside. And Lulu just said, nah, fine, I'll just call it. Take that.
So we're going to get a team timeout, the final timeout from Angel City.
1 minute, 16 seconds on the clock. Bay Area, 228 points to Angel City's 89.
This team timeout brought to you by Roller Derby Athletics. Roller Derby Athletics can change your game in 30 seconds, too. Find out more at rollerderbyathletics.com. So what's impressive about Bay Area is that within their four-jammer rotation, there is not necessarily one breakaway. Huxin is at the top of the tally with 65, but listen to this. Right after her at 59 is Lulu Lockjaw. Then behind her is Knock Knock with 58. And then right behind her is Brick Tater with 46. I can't imagine what forces of nature would be able to put together a better jammer rotation than that. A lot of times you'll see maybe a 4 or 5 jammer rotation with like 2 or 3 that are super effective and huge point scorers like Angel City's Chicago Lightning. But those points are just insane for this team.
This is a team, they have come so far in just a few years' time. I remember when they definitely were not this controlled and this
yes.
disciplined and trying to bring everyone up to the same level. And it is remarkable that they do have such a strong jammer rotation, and their blocker crew is just ridiculous.
So Brick Tater has gotten through to become lead jammer, but there has been a star pass. Stormy Heather started out and passed to Britches. Britches has it now. And it looks like Brick Tater is actually doing some of her own defense, which she's doing right now.
I think she's looked like she was trying to get some baby eating happening there. And she's just going to stay on Britches. I think she's just running the clock at this point.
Agreed. And so Britches stuffing the helmet cover in her jersey. Still going around following Brick Tater, though.
Jane Wilkins, Stormy Heather, taking a seat in the Notorious RED penalty box. That is a full blocker box right now. I'm a Blobaya, Booty Ninja, the only defenders on the track, trying to keep Brick Tater back.
Brick Tater took a look behind her to see how many seconds were left in the period. The period clock has expired. And there we go. 4 more points for Angel City, though, at the end. Conan running onto the track to have some words, though, with Lauren Order. And that does not look like a happy exchange.
Well, and I'm going to go out on a limb here and say it's not going to affect the final outcome in that Bay Area gets their bye for Nashville. They have decisively won against Angel City 228-93, the unofficial final. So they win the championship of this divisional playoff here in Salt Lake City this weekend. Angel City, though, they were third in their divisionals last year. So they moved up a spot this year, and that is very, very impressive.
That's got to feel really good for them. The story of Angel City in this game, certainly people were wondering, well, how ineffective really was Chris Dobbins in that game against Fight Club? 24 points is still an impressive showing. She was the fourth scoring jammer, especially if we're talking about Stormy Heather, who was only grabbing 6 points in this game. So that's certainly maybe a choice that cost them a few points. We'll never know. But penalties, over 50 penalties in this game for Angel City. Bay Area was still able to keep it under 30 with 29 penalties, so more than they certainly would have liked. I know Bay Area likes to get 25 or fewer penalties in a game.
Not too bad, though, to only get 4 penalties above their maximum that they are comfortable with. The Angel City, it's interesting because last season I thought their biggest weakness was their penalties. Mm-hmm. And this season, they did more traveling, mm-hmm. exposed themselves to more ref crews, so they got used to different type of calls. But Bay Area just proved that they still know how Angel City plays. They still know how to push Angel City's buttons. So it's going to be interesting to see what Angel City does in Nashville, and to see if the other teams are going to figure out what Bay Area has already figured out.
I mean, the interesting thing about Angel City is that I almost feel like this game for them was as much a mental game as it was anything else, because they've beaten Denver this year.
Yes.
They've beaten Windy City, so they've got some really impressive wins under their belt, but just coming in against, it's like the older sister syndrome, right? Constantly putting her hand against your forehead and you're like, oh, let me at you. And I think it really gets in their heads that Bay Area is the team that they just haven't taken down yet.
I think Angel City is kind of like Jan Brady right now.
Marsha! Absolutely correct. Well, Marsha, Jan, and Cindy, that's the number one, the number two, and the number three seeds in this tournament, are about to collect their awards. So we're going to take an opportunity to thank one more round of sponsors in this tournament before we turn it over to the tournament award ceremony. I'm so sorry that Moxie had to miss the second half of this call, but I'm Double H, and this is Tara Armoff. And we'll be back to join you after the awards to thank a lot of people and see you off to Charleston. We'll be back in just a few.
Began in our Las Vegas living room in 2005, the first shop ever dedicated to roller derby, and has since grown into this 2,000 square foot mecca in San Diego, where we stock everything for our sport. Need help? With a combined on-track experience of over 24 years and still playing, we test everything we sell, and we're happy to share that experience and knowledge with you. So contact us, SinCitySkates.com.
WFTDA.TV.